Okay, hello and welcome to week 7 of our leadership development program. So we've made it to week 7. So we get to talk about chapter 7 as well, of course, which is the power close. So this chapter was really fun because it talks about how to handle a lot of the objections that we get, how to deal with getting a no, what you can say that might help turn it around so that no doesn't mean no forever, it just means no for right now, and just a little bit of the mindset of how you deal with rejection and dealing with getting the no, and what to say when somebody's like, yeah, no thanks, not interested, or not interested because of this or whatever. So she talks about how a lot of times we don't ever even get to the no because we don't ask, because we fear. We fear that we don't know enough. We fear that we won't know how to answer their questions. Sorry, my hair's crazy in my eyes. There we go. We are afraid of what to say. We won't know. So she said she uses her method of feel, felt, found. So that instead of saying, when somebody says, no thanks, or, you know, I'm not into fragrances, or I'm fine buying, you know, the grocery store brand or whatever, then you use the feel, felt, found method, where you say, I understand how you feel, and I felt the same way, but I found this to be the case. Or I understand how you feel that you're a little bit worried about this. And honestly, I was the same way. I felt the same thing. But since I've been a consultant, I found that it's actually a lot easier to get my minimums than I need. Or, you know, whatever it is, the feel, felt, found is a really good way for you to validate their concerns and then not just shut them down and say, well, it's not like that at all or anything. It helps really have a good comeback that helps you equate with them and really still be able to assure them that it'll be fine and that it'll all work out and that it's good for them to take the leap, even if it's a little scary. So she then goes through some different questions that she's gotten with that are some different objections. So she goes through there and she does it beautifully. So I won't go over those. So go ahead and look. She goes through the objections. What does it cost to get started? How does it work? What will I be doing? How do I make money? I'm so busy. I don't have enough time to do this. I don't have enough money to get started. I'm not a salesperson. I don't know anybody. I don't want to bug my friends and my family. I need to try the products first. Is it a pyramid scheme? So I have probably heard every single one of those questions as I've gone through my recruiting pitch, if you will, and inviting people to come join my team. And like I said, a lot of times she is very simple in her answer of how she does it and how she answers the questions. So you use the feel, felt, found method, and then you also talk about simple answers. You want them to feel excited and not overwhelmed. So they don't need to know every detail when they say, how do you make money with Scentsy? You don't need to go into the whole compensation plan. We've talked about this before. If they say, well, how do I, you know, how much does it cost to get started? You don't need to go into all of the details of every little, you know, of everything. Just give her an overview because you don't want to be misleading, but just don't overwhelm with too many details. There's plenty of time for coaching and mentoring after they're already on board, and then you can show them all the details of how to do everything, but that way they get excited. On the what does it cost to get started, that's a very common question that we'll hear, and I really liked, she, in her business, they have different starter kit options because it's a skincare product, and so you'll buy a bigger kit. Anyway, we only have one option, at least for now. So she says, no matter which starter kit you choose, we have a fast start bonus to help you earn your ROI right away. The thing that I like about that is I say the same thing. I was nervous to join. I didn't know if I would know enough people. I didn't know if I'd be good at it. I didn't know if I would even like it and want to stick around because I'd never done direct sales or anything like it. I'm not super social. I'm not a party girl. So all of those things that everybody has objections and challenges with, hey, that's me. I've been there, done that. I feel the same way. So for me, it's very easy to empathize and say, I totally understand how you're feeling. I felt that same way before I started. I was really worried about not being a piranha and being so annoying to my friends and family. I was worried about not doing well. I was worried about not having any customers. I mean, all of those same things, you've probably felt your share of worries and fears as well. So that's where we really can relate one-on-one to them and really give them our empathy, and then they will also feel your encouragement, as you say, I was worried about, you know, if I would like it or if I would do very well at it as well. That's the beauty of, at least in the United States, it's $99. So you can give them your amount, your startup kit, obviously. So I always tell people, you know, it was $99. I knew that that was my startup cost. So I booked enough parties so that I could sell $500 worth of product. Because like I said, in my region, $500 is the shooting star kit, but it's also the commission that would make back my startup kit money. So I always say I tried to get that in the first month to make sure I could pay that back with my commissions. That way, if I didn't like it, I could walk away and it wouldn't have any effect or harm to my family. That's the beauty of it, is you might think they're a super rock star and they might end up being a superstar director. But it's okay if they're a little bit hesitant to start, or if they don't even think they're gonna wanna be in it. It's okay to give them an out without having them feel this huge pressure to, you have to sell $500 a month, and you have to do this, and you have to recruit and promote, and blah, 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 blah. Again, simple, easy, fun, and then they will catch the vision and take it bigger and broader if they would like to. Like I said, I was one who started worried that I wouldn't like it, that I wouldn't be any good at it, and so I was one who started thinking, okay, how do I recoup this in case I want to walk away? And so that's okay. It's okay to reassure them that they will make their return on investment right away, and it won't be, you know, hundreds of dollars in inventory or a big, huge startup kit. That's why I love that we have such an affordable startup kit cost, and that our shooting star kit really does help. If they earn that in their first 2 weeks, the commissions from that really does help to make them profitable in their first month. So anyway, like I said, she's got a lot of great, great tips and hints as well. So here is my challenge for this week. We're kind of starting to slack on the challenges. I gave you a little bit of a leeway last week to finish things and to catch up, and it seems like there wasn't a whole lot of action on there as far as catching up from previous challenges. So that's okay, but let's do this one this week. So for those of you who did it last week and who posted your conversation, your elevator pitch, great job. Hopefully you are practicing that over and over and it has become second nature and is easy for you to share. So here is what I want you to do this week. Of course, post the chapter favorites, your highlights, whatever you liked, or even just one little part, something that you are going to do, what stood out to you. The second thing I want you to do is to get 10 no's. So we are going to deal with this power close and the rejection and getting over that fear by going after the no. A lot of times I think we're simply just afraid of having somebody say no, but if you're looking for the no, then it's okay. And if they say yes, even better, but your goal is to get 10 no's. So remember, lead with the opportunity. So go and ask 10 people to join your team, call them, and post one of those conversations on our team page. It can be the funniest one, it can be the saddest one, it can be just one example of one conversation you had getting a no, and then share that with us so we can commiserate and pat each other on the back for a job well done and doing something super scary, as well as maybe we can even delve into maybe something we could have said to help turn that around and maybe help them decide that it was time. I also love that she says a no, because I say this all the time too. A no doesn't always mean no forever. It just means no for right now. So even if you post your conversation of your saddest no, it's okay. That doesn't mean that that person's never going to be on your team, especially if they're on your short list of 10, your dream team that you would love to work with. Don't give up on them. It just means that they weren't ready right then, and you can give them another opportunity later. So, and then the third thing that I want you to do, well, kind of the fourth if you count the post your no conversation, but that's kind of part of your 10 no's. But so then the last thing that I wanted you to do is post the Ascent Academy Challenge and what you did to accomplish it. So if you are not using the Ascent Academy to grow your business, that needs to change, because that's a huge resource that we have, and it's daily challenges to help you grow your business. And then that way, when you are done with this program in just 3 short weeks, you won't be all of a sudden at the end and thinking, now what do I do every day? Because you've not only gotten in the habit of doing these challenges, but you also have gotten in the habit of checking your Ascent Academy every day, especially at the beginning of the week, checking them. And if you don't want to do all 5 or all 7, that's okay. Pick 2 or 3 from the week to do. Decide which ones you're going to do, and then Get in the habit of always doing your Scent Academy challenge. So for this week, look through the week and just pick one or two of them that you want to do. Challenge yourself. It's up to you. I'll let you decide if you're just in a really overwhelmed time. I know we've got a newborn baby, we've got a new job, we've got somebody who just moved. Whatever your situation is, again, I want to push you and challenge you, but I don't want to overwhelm. So if you're up for a challenge and if you get your 10 no's really quickly, then go on and do a couple of challenges. If all you can do is just one for the week, do at least one. So what are your challenges? The chapter takeaways, that's always our favorite. And then the second thing is get your 10 no's and then post one of those conversations of rejection onto our team page, share it with us. And then the third thing is, like I said, to choose one of your Scent Academy challenges and do it this week. Share with us what the challenge was and what you did. Post a picture of it. Post some kind of proof so that we can cheer you on and see it in action and get ideas from your good ideas. If it was, you know, create a recognition for your team, we'd love to see that. So whatever it is, post it so that we can share and get good ideas from your good ideas. So anyway, you guys are awesome. Have a great week. Here's to a super week 7 and keep chugging. You guys are doing great. And just keep going up that mountain and looking for those prospects. Lead with the opportunity and your 10 no's will help you to invite more people this week. So I can't wait to welcome all of your new team members. So ready, set, go.